You don't know who you are until you see your own reflection. So it's important for us on the largest stage in the world, arguably, to see our stories, to see our journey reflected back to us, to know that we too sing America and deserve for all our spectrum of who we are to be represented. Broadway celebrates Juneteenth is presented by the Broadway League Black to Broadway initiative. And the goal of Black to Broadway is to inspire a deeper engagement with awareness of and access to Broadway for all Black people. Now, this is the third time we've done it. This is the annual event that's held in Times Square. It's a free event, a free concert that features more than 25 Black Broadway performers that will be singing and dancing and reciting spoken words. So it's an excellent and exciting event, and I'm honored to be a part of it.
I love the vision and the imagery of all these talented Broadway stars together, you know, singing, performing, giving us words of inspiration on a day like Juneteenth. How hard is it to get all of these stars together, and what are some of the different productions that they come from? Tell us who tends to participate.
Yes, it is an exciting venture to get all these people together. And we put out an application or ask for these artists to be a part. And a lot of the shows and a lot of people willingly are excited about this performance. So you have performance for current Broadway shows that will happen. Our host is Disney's own Aladdin. Michael James Scott is our host for this performance. You will also see from Shucked on Broadway, from Sweeney Todd on Broadway, just all the current Broadway shows. We have a preview of the upcoming revival of The Wiz, which is coming up next week, will also be a preview performance from that show. Yes, so it is a lot of great Black performers coming together and celebrating. And also, let me shout out, we do a Juneteenth Legendary or Legacy Award honoree, which this year goes to Kenny Leon, whom shoulders we stand on.
Oh, Kenny Leon is a giant in the Broadway space and beyond.
Yes.
So I love hearing that. That's amazing. That is amazing. I want to shout out the fact that you were the director for Thoughts of a Colored Man in 2021. This was the first Broadway show written and directed by a Black man, starring a Black man. I mean, that is incredible. For so many people, Broadway may seem kind of like it's out of reach or it's just for a certain type of patron. Why do you think it's important for us to tell our stories on the theater's biggest stage?
Yes, like you quoted me when you started, you don't know who you are until you see your own reflection. So it's important for us on the largest stage in the world, arguably, to see our stories, to see our journey reflected back to us, to know that we too sing America and deserve for all our spectrum of who we are to be represented. So I believe that's why it's important.
Absolutely. Juneteenth, this has been called a Black Independence Day. And I just want to get your take. What do you think Black independence looks like in the realm of Broadway? I know that we are often, you know, the stars of shows and we have talent. We're celebrated for our talent. But I imagine that there is a fight. There is a liberation fight that happens in the arts community and the theater community for Black people. So what does that look like for you?
I think highlighting Black liberation or independence on Broadway to me looks like a continual representation. Again, not only on stage, behind the stage management, producing, owning our own houses and houses that present shows. So being involved in all aspects, writing, creating, producing, performing by people of color, Black folks specifically. So I believe that's what independence looks like as we continue to grow and diversify and state our claim on Broadway.